hello you. Before we get started, you can win a copy of Cartel Tycoon. Just stick around to the end of the video to find out how. Hello you, welcome to Geekism and welcome to Cartel Tycoon. This is a survival business sim inspired by the 80s narco trade. We had a brief look at this one a little while ago in a demo version. It is now in a full early access and it's recently had a big update as well. So I thought we would definitely come back and take another look at it. Thank you so much to Tiny Build for providing me not only with a key for this video but also for sponsoring this video as well. Sponsor videos really do help us keep in team bags here at Geekism, and we thank them very much for their support. So far we've got a story and a sandbox mode. There's also a survival and multiplayer mode even coming in the future. For now I think we'll start with story just to make sure we really know what we're doing, and we're going to create a new save. We get to make our sort of drug lord, I guess, but we're not actually going to necessarily stay with that person. One of the big features of this game is that if your main character dies, one of your peons move up the ranks to take on the role. So it's like a dynasty management as well, which is pretty cool. So we're starting off as Cesar Garcetti. Caesar takes a long drag of his cigarette, steadying his nerves. The dial tone hums, then cracks. Love the art style. I think the character art style is incredible. Reminds me a little bit of the like the GTA loading screens, you know? It's got that kind of, drawn but still a bit realistic. Yeah, I like it. Hello. Hola. My name is... I'm not going to do the accent, don't worry. My name is Cesar Garcetti. I'm calling about your ad in the paper. You're looking for a partner. I am. Strange voice is rich, smooth, and warm like fresh brewed coffee. Well, we drink tea here, but that's fine. Love or business? Perhaps I have the wrong number. Depends what you're looking for, senor. I don't know what that word is. I don't have time to be church around. I have to pause from the receiver. Caesar takes another prolonged pull of his dwindling cigarettes. My apologies. Let's start over. Caesar, see? There's money to be made from this land, but it's buried far too deep for the reach of one man alone. I need a dependable partner. Can I count on you? You time me just like that? You're clearly capable. I will lend you one of my residences in the cache in its walls. You'll oversee my fledgling operation. It's simple horticulture, growing and selling flowers. There you go. You'll think of it as a test. Before he can respond, the cigarette burns his fingertips. It causes him pain, and the stranger laughs again. Marveloso. When she's done, I'll be in touch. Nice. So we're in this city then. Let's have a look. So one of the other main things about this is that there are two currencies. We have legal money and dirty money. So I think dirty money is we're going to be using to buy stuff, and we have to launder it into legal cash, perhaps. I think it's something like that. Okay, simple horticulture currency. Using dirty money, build 3 opium farms within range of this residence. Using dirty money, build a warehouse and connect the warehouse and the farms with roads. Okay, so here's our residence, residence number 3. And we're going to want to build, let's have a look, farms. Okay, so I guess this looks like it's quite good efficiency up here. Okay, let's do that. Can we rotate? Yeah, Z and X rotate. Okay, great. So we want 3 farms here, wasn't it? Yeah, so let's do 1, 2. Make sure we get that 3 efficiency in each of those. Great, and also a warehouse. Communication, there we go, warehouse. Right over here, maybe. There we go, and then roads. How did we do a road? Oh, a sandy road is fine. Okay, so we'll pick it off here. And we can snap them onto there. Okay, so if we go like this. Up to here. And then each of these roads, whoopsie-daisy, each of these roads can pop onto here. And now, oh, there we go. We've now got the builders coming in. Nice. And our farms are getting built. And then we connect. So that should be everything. Yeah, build three farms. They're getting done. Do we have to select that they're going to be opium? Or no, it does it already. Okay, cool. Oh, I see. That was actually opium ground we were looking at there as well. So different plants will have better chance of growing in certain spots. Okay. So we have three. And then our warehouse will get done now as well, I hope. I love how we're just right by the main road, like, not even... don't look over here, it's fine. Okay, our farms are in and getting stored in the warehouse. We now have to move Caesar to the warehouse using his Lieutenant's General abilities. Okay, so General Orders, move him. Oh yeah, he's still in the city. We want to get you out of there, buddy. We need somewhere that's a bit safer. Let's have a look. Here he comes in a cab. Excellent. Yeah, I'm loving the music as well. So at the moment, we're doing this by hand. We are going to deliver, let's have a look, deliver opium to the airport. So, you know, first time, we've got to do it by hand. Okay, we've got a little convoy, I like it. But I assume eventually we can set up systems to do this automatically, you know, because already they're moving stuff from here to here, which is good. But we're having to come through the city. That's not good. We want to keep out of the way of the big boys, really. Because obviously, you know, we're on the wrong side of the law here. So we're going to have to deal with the police and what have you. They can do various raids on the buildings and other things. Oh, look at this. Coming soon. Indigenous territory story. Oh, we can store stuff there. Yeah, that's interesting. What about over this one? What's that? That's just a few buildings. Okay, here we go. We're going to take opium up to the airport. It's not much of an airport, really. It's an airstrip, if nothing else, really. There they go. And then we need to turn it on. Let's power it on. Nice. So, obviously, it costs us to keep this thing running. But this is where we're going to ship out the merchandise, right? Set the aerodrome as a destination for the warehouse. Okay, how do we do that? Here we go. So from the warehouse, we can click add new destination and set the aerodrome to be one. There we go. So deliver opium to the aerodrome using the warehouse. So they're going to take stuff there and roll out with it. So I wonder if we can add our own roads in here. Like, I know it's only a sandy, poor road, but can we do, like... something like that to kind of avoid the city. That'd be pretty good because it's a long way around, right? I mean, I don't know whether or not up here we're going to be able to do it, but yeah, we can't do it there. We've got like a zone we can build in. Look, I wonder if we can eventually unlock more space. Amado we are in right now. There we go, Amado. Yeah. Now, these two set off before I put this road in, so maybe the next ones that go. Warehouse 1 will automatically service any farms in its radius. Okay, cool. Residence contains your startup capital. Dirty money uses money to build your production capabilities. Build farms where efficiency is highest and maximize your yield. We did that. We were good. Okay, opium is off. There goes the plane. Let's see it go off. Excellent. So we're in the money now, surely. Are we earning? I'm not sure. Let's have a look. Smuggling points, aerodromes, seaports, and checkpoints are locations where you can turn produce into dirty money. You can only sell illegal goods through aerodromes, and you'll receive dirty money in return. Okay, so produce 25 units of opium on farms, and sell 25 units of opium through the aerodrome. Okay, well that's just, hopefully, we can just kind of let that happen. I feel like it's just gonna work its own way there. So these are filling up, I see. So this, I assume this is empty at the moment then. Let's have a look if we can see. Total storage capacity is 125. And there is currently, does it tell us how many is actually in there right now? Ah, there we go. So now it's starting to fill up, I see. So we have 12 opium sat in that warehouse. And we've got 12 on the way. Okay, so it seems to be that they take it from the farms to the warehouse and then from the warehouse out to the airport. That makes complete sense. So yeah, this one is early access at the moment. It's looking like a 1.0 version is going to be planned for the end of the year. You know, maybe the beginning of 2022. You can get involved with the development and help shape the game into, you know, one of your dreams. You can join the rapidly growing community of drug kingpins. There are links in the description to Cartel Tycoon's socials. You can follow them on YouTube. They upload their own videos there. And also there is a Discord as well. I'm in that one. I'll pop all the details down into the description for those. Excelente. All the stuff has moved to the airport. The only thing I did was actually realize that there was no reason for it to sort of come around the house here. So we moved the road as well. Caesar lugs the last crate onto the back of the small prop plane. The pilot approaches him, offering a large black telephone. Oh, nice. The guy, Caesar, Shay's voice is unmistakable. I could almost kiss you. You've built us a strong foundation. Trust a man of faith to turn a profit so quickly. You know me well for a caller I've never met. How do you know I am a religious man? Is it strange for a man to research his new business partner? My mother is a God-fearing woman. I practice for her sake. But the truth is that business is off far greater interest of me than piety. Business I would like to return to, partner. A son loyal to his mother is a precious thing. And as I am sure she would agree, clean hands offend no one. Dirty money is like coal, a powerful fuel, but one that blackens the hands and leaves a mess everywhere. We will need to scrub our hands clean. Our hands? I have provided you with new funds. Well, think of it as an investment, see? Use it as a... buy us a taxi company in Amado. I'll be in touch soon. Okay, so here's how we're going to basically launder some of our dirty money into legal money, I imagine, and maybe vice versa. I'm not sure, but here's the city of Armado. Let's have a look. You can purchase buildings with unique benefits in cities. The number of buildings that can be built varies. Okay, so here's the mayor. Sierra is hit with young voters. He lights up a campaign trail vehement about social justice and fresh opportunities, but without stability, he's just an idealist, peddling false hope. Maybe a backroom deal can offer the PC craves. Pair of trust. Respect the people's wishes is essential if you want to depend on them. Increase loyalty, eliminate gang presence, and deliver cash. Okay. Well, I don't want to ask for a favor just now, but we are under control. The city is under our control, which is nice. Buildings. Here we go. Taxi company. Launders dirty money that lieutenants, all the residences deliver from smuggling points. Okay, cool. Launder cash 1,800 every 3 days. Yeah, go for it. Build it. It's under construction. Okay. So we have that. Using Caesar, transport dirty money from the aerodrome to the taxi company and then turn it on and then launder some actual cash as well. So I'm interested to see... Like these are already done, I guess, here, but I suppose if we moved into new cities, like, yeah, we don't have those, I see. But we're going to slowly take over the world. Los Grande. Oh, wow, the map's huge. Fascani, Chapirica, Rogandes. I apologize to any sort of Spanish-speaking people that I'm assumingly absolutely bastardizing the names of these places, but I love the style of it. It reminds me a little bit of Tropico, especially with the music as well. I'm really digging the music. Okay, the taxi company is getting built, and then we'll send Caesar over there. We are going to move. Oh, no, it didn't say move, did it? Just transport dirty money. Okay, so deliver. I'm going to assume it's that one. Keep picking up until ordered otherwise. No, we'll take $5,000 over to the taxi company. I think that's right. I love how he has a little convoy. He's not in a cab, it's just a yellow car. I was like, it's weird that he's in a cab and people follow him. No, I love it. I love the RV at the back as well. Very Breaking Bad. He's going to take all this cash over here. And now I wonder if, because we can't just turn everything into legal money because we need dirty money to expand the place. So it's going to be a bit of a fine line as to how we manage the resources, I suppose. Here it comes. Taxi company has stopped operating. I guess it's just got no money. Let's have a look. Laundering, 3 days. There we go. We took money there. We turned it on, which I assume... There it is. Yeah, on. Okay. Launder 1800 dirty money into legal money at the taxi company. It's currently done nothing, but it will do 1980. I wonder where we get the 180 bonus from there. Maybe it's because we're there. But either way, we are making bank. We're washing that cash. Okay, in the garbage of a rundown Armado taxi company, Caesar watches as the remaining stacks of cash are hauled out to the back of an old car. The smell of freshly laundered cash. It's beautiful, is it not? Garage reeks of paint, gasoline, and perspiration. Caesar bites his tongue, stretches out his back, and lets out a strained breath. Truly, Caesar, I'm impressed. You're working hard. Yes, yes. Too hard. If you continue like this, you will break your back before you enjoy the fruits of your labor. It's hard work, but someone wants to do it. If you are truly concerned, by all means, come and lend a hand yourself. Did I entrust you with my residence and the lieutenants there, the drivers, who will only be too happy to share the workload? Just tell them what to do, and they will do it until you tell them to stop. Synergy, my friend. Make the system work for you. Yeah, so now we're going to... All of this needs to be automated, right? Because the taxi company's stopping because it's got no dirty cash. Okay, so here we go. Select the aerodrome as a destination for the residents. Okay, so the residents. Add the aerodrome. I'm 100% sure what that one does. Select the taxi company as a destination for the residents. Oh, maybe this is... So the money goes from the residents, right? Not yeah, and the merchandise goes from the warehouse. There we go. Yeah, so people will start taking cash around now. Excellent. Launder 3,600 dirty money into legal money at the taxi company. Okay, well, again, it should just be a time thing. We've sped the time up a little bit now. So let's have a look. They'll do, in 10 hours, they'll do 1,980. So every few days, that will just pop some of our dirty money into legal money. But like I say, we can't just shift all of it because this stuff is bought with dirty money, right? Oh, hold on. Or is it bought with both? Oh, it looks like we can buy it with either or. Okay, well, that's good to know. Yeah. And we can buy more residences that do stuff. Okay. Chemical plants? Wow, so we're not going to just be making the raw plants here as well. We're actually going to be synthesizing them into powders and pills, I guess. So what's the difference between a plantation and a farm? Maybe just the size of it? Let's have a look. Occupying a significant area, plantations produce legal and illegal raw materials in large quantities. Cannot be placed on maintenance strain. Yeah, so I guess it's just a bigger operation, basically. We need to speculate to accumulate. We need to expand and grow. Feels good to be in charge, no? Many hands make light work. Yes, I still believe it would benefit from a few more. More drivers? No, my friend. They are cogs in the machine. Lieutenants will carry out these more complex tasks. I've been reaching out. Soon you'll be able to take your pick of novatos at the residence. We'll make a leader out of you yet. Caesar laughs and drops a cigarette from his mouth onto the hardwood floor of the office, crushing it between his toes. If being a leader like you requires me to become only a voice at the end of a telephone wire, I'm not interested. Tell me how I am different from one of these cogs. I don't even know your name. So this is true. I understand your frustration. Perhaps it is time to introduce myself formally. Carry out this task and I will see you soon, Caesar Garcetti. Okay. Hire lieutenants at the residence. Maintain at least 2 lieutenants in the cartel. Okay. Recruit lieutenants. Let's go. Oh, nice. We get to pick. And they've got various abilities and stuff. Okay. So Vanessa Diaz. Hired killer. Based on that question, perhaps Vanessa's heart was stolen long ago. And she's free. Okay. She has kidnapping perks. Harvest. It reduces farm raw material production interval by 5% in an area. Okay, that's good. She has 2... I don't really know what a lot of these mean yet, but, you know. Tony Quintero, he looks badass. He has affects the selling price of cocaine increased by 30%. Wow, that's huge. I know we're not making cocaine yet, but that's pretty good. Guy's so big and menacing that his very presence is often enough to subdue opponents. Here, Wilson, who's regarding this from Langerations, defending it fiercely. Oh, I mean, they all look cool. She looks awesome as well. Alcazar. Years ago. I don't know. I like the straight up, like, just more money one. Raw material by 5%. And raw material 5%. So they've all got raw material apart from Tony, who basically gives us more money on cocaine. Assuming we're gonna be making cocaine soon, we're gonna take on Tony. There we go. I mean, it says we can recruit more. I don't know whether we should or not. Let's not just for now. Let's stick to what the game wants us to do. Creature turns allegiance by increasing their upkeep. Okay, so let's have a look. Here he is. Upkeep free. Ah, I see. Raise upkeep. Allegiance. Ah, I see. So he can become zealous, loyal, dedicated, disaffected, disloyal, or volatile. Right, okay. So let's do it small account. We'll keep him dedicated. Or we can do a large amount, which will keep him loyal. Let's go large amount then. Let's keep him on our side. Oh, here we go. We're going to find out who's been calling the shots. We're going to find out who the dealer is. What was the guy from Deal or No Deal? The banker. This guy's just on the phone. He's the banker. He's here. Miguel Angel Garcha. Residents alive with noise. I love what you've done with the place. Room full silence. As he sees, he recognizes the voice. Rich, smooth, and warm, like fresh brewed coffee. It's nice to finally meet you, partner. Please, call me Miguel. So you exchange greetings before Caesar introduces Miguel to his lieutenants. You've hired well, even so, be wary. Every lieutenant has needs, money, or power. Satisfy these needs, and you'll have their allegiance. A valuable thing indeed. Fail, however, and they may become disaffected, unpredictable. There are ways to solve this. Your purse or your pistol? Bueno, Sarah. But for now, I need your sword rather than your pen. Our business is growing, but so must our supply. There's a seaport in Puerto Roja, owned by another gang. Gather your strongest lieutenants and we'll take it from them. You'll come in? Ha-ha! This is the start of a new chapter for us, Caesar. Nice. Okay, so we are doing a hostile takeover. Here it is. And I assume with that we can take on the city as well. You can't sell legal goods openly through the seaport. You need to pack them inside legal goods, such as vegetables. Okay. Well, we're going to go there. Move lieutenants with enough power to the enemy seaport in Puerto Rico. So does it tell us what power we need? Let's have a look. Smuggling point. It just says enemy gang. Capture it. I mean, we just... Oh, there we go. It has 3 power. I see. So I guess this is like a top trumps kind of thing. So he has 0 power. Excellent. He has 4 power, though. He's pretty badass. And we have 3 power. So if we move to here, then... So we've got... Can we move everyone together? And let's go for it. How do we like, multi-select them? Or do we do them all at once? Okay. I'm going to move you. Here we go. You're about to send a lieutenant. This will trigger a territory war. 4-3. Proceed. Can we also send me to help? I don't know. Let's see how it works. We're gonna take him on. Okay, it's going. I see. So currently it's kind of... So we're there. Yeah, so we're helping. We're pushing that forward. Okay, well, I'm tempted to send everyone. Well, he has no power, though, so I don't think there's that much point in it. It'll be done by the time he gets there anyway, won't it? There we go. These 2 have gone in. Guns blazing, man. Excellent. Seaboard is painted red. Caesar approaches. Have you seen Miguel? He left orders for you to begin establishing a supply chain to the seaport, Capo. He said be cautious and use a workshop. A workshop? Customs officers, gringos, check any cargo that goes by road or sea. So we must smuggle them in legal produce. We should get straight to work. The man you're dealing with, his name is Miguel Gacha, but they call him El Vironas. The same El Vironas that seduces victims before stealing their souls. Put no stock in monikers, my friend. They're no less of a facade, I'm not sure about that one, than our false cargo. They call me Gustanito. Would you think me a worm? Why do you suppose he was looking for a new partner? Because his former friend was left holding the bag, and now he's inside. You should be careful. You my mother? If I spent time chasing suspicion, I'd have no time for anything else. Come, Logatine, have some faith. We have work to do. I'm listening to him, man. I think we need to worry a little. Build a workshop, produce 40 units of opium packed into vegetables, and then sell. Oh. Place any tents inside seaport in Puerto Regent. He's there, isn't he? Smuggling boats must be held with the help of the tenants, otherwise you will lose control. Okay, well, he's there, isn't he? Yeah, he's there. Oh, yeah, it's saying it's done. Sorry, that was dumb. We didn't have long to do it, though. Okay, well, you get back to the house. Tony, you hang out there. Okay, that was good. That was a bit of a worry, but we're okay. Produce 40 units of opium at packs. So do we have this space to build in now? I guess we do, right? Oh, the enemy gang has all sorts here, look. Well, part of me wants to just take this over. Plantation and a warehouse. And build a workshop. Yeah, come on, let's go for it. Go for it, Tony. Caesar, sorry. 3-1, proceed. Seaport is captured. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we captured it. How's it going? It's going okay. I want to take another lieutenant on. Someone with good power. Two there. Recruit. Hire. And we'll set your... We'll get you loyal as well. And now you come to here. Come and help us out. Excellent. So we're going to take that, and then we'll build, and this can be our vegetable opium. There we go. So we'll turn it on. You can start making. We will now move you to here, and we'll send you there as well. And we'll take this over. Oh yeah, this is much better. I don't think we'd even build these yet. Research required, but we can take over one that's already there. Plantation is yours now. It's not operating yet, but you can switch it on in the selection menu. Yeah, we did that, didn't we? Excellent. So it's making up nice opium. Okay. And then we'll own this. Excellent. We'll turn that on. And then we'll build a workshop across the road. Oh, does it want to attach that way? Okay. Ah, it says we cannot build in this region. Oh, well, that's okay. Well, we'll build it over here then. That's fine. I guess because we own that place now. Maybe we don't. Oh, we don't own the city, I suppose, is the idea, is it? We don't own the city. Okay. Well, here we go. Then there's a workshop going down. And then we just have to send stuff across the bridge, I suppose. Okay. You come back to the house. And you can stay there for now. Okay, so what do we have to do here? We have to put opium into vegetables, that's right. Now we need we need to make our own vegetables as well. Okay, so you are opium. Right, encounter started at a warehouse. Okay, so let's do this then. Let's set that a destination to be there. Okay, so they're going to bring... There we go. They're going to bring opium to there. That's not the most ideal run because it's all sat here, but that's fine. And then we need to build some regular farms for fruit and veg. Okay, I mean, this is all opium. Can we pick what it is? Oh, there we go. Vegetables. Oh, I see. Oh, we need some more legal money for these. Or can we not build it out of that money? There we go. So we don't have very efficient vegetable space, but I think we're just going to have to deal with it, unfortunately. Now, I feel like these are probably going to be okay here, because they're legal, right? We're just making vegetables. That's a good, a solid business, right? Yeah? Okay, so now what I think we want to do is turn them off. And we'll have another workshop that... They will have another warehouse that just holds the veggies. Okay. So we'll put that there. Oh, it's not quite close enough. That's annoying. Maybe we have to move it closer then, I suppose. Let's build another one. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that's my fault. There is a complete thing around it. Let's put it here. Let's put it there. That needs a road to it, sure. There we go. Okay, now this one is just those farms. And then here. Okay, so additional destinations. Oh, it's automatic, is it? I suppose we gotta wait for them to grow, right? There we go. DEA has started investigating the aerodrome. What does that mean? You got your first attention star. The DEA will now periodically conduct a border investigation. During the border investigation, the selling price of products will be lower. If you continue to use the smuggling point whilst it's under investigation, the smuggling point will be seized. Okay, so we turn it off then, right? We have to just sit on it for a little while. Zero legal money though. Why are we not making much legal money? Maybe we need to get another operation going there. Yeah, there we go. Oh, because that's close enough just to work. Okay, well that's good. So we need a... Building has no reachable destinations. So now we send... Now we can send those things to there. Is that right? Not quite sure how they quite link up, but there we go. We've got 17 there, 51 opium in vegetables. Excellent. The DEA look like they're done here. You can switch between different types of money to pay for the upkeep of smuggling ports. Ah. Smuggling points must be held with the help of a lieutenant, otherwise you will lose control over them and they will fall into enemy's hands. An exception is aerodromes. They don't need to be held. Okay, so this one we can leave. Okay, good. So we turn that back on now. Oh, I see. Yeah, it's using legal money there. Well, let's do that with... No, let's keep it legal money just to keep the heat off us a little, eh? Okay, I completely had that messed up. There was absolutely no problems here. The seaport just wasn't turned on. So we've now linked up the residency in the seaport, so we're taking some cash over there for old Tony. Here it goes. Chuck, 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 chuck. There's loads of luck sat in there. Crazy. And the first vegetables are going there. What on earth is happening over here? We had to pay bribes to get through there. My goodness. Okay. Well, that's what we got to do, I suppose. We need to try and take over. I can't imagine we can build roads here. Yeah, we can't build here, so we have to pay that. Okay. Well, we've got the opium package now. Now we just need to ship some of it out to where it's got to go. Let's see, this guy's bringing 3,600 luck. Yeah. 12. Okay, so it doesn't take merchandise off us, but it does take cash off us as we come through. This one's bringing 1,000 in luck. And it takes 300. Wow, we need to get hold of Puerto Rico quick. Was it Puerto Rico, sorry? Puerto Roja. Yeah. But otherwise, I think we've got stuff here. We have 12 there. There we go. But I assume it doesn't sell until an actual boat turns up. Here it comes. Let's see. And the DEA started investigating it. Oh, no, that's the old thing. There we go. Okay. There we go. We shipped some out. Fantastic. Okay. Wow. I like it. There's a lot of, like different chains that we have to keep an eye on here. This is being investigated again. So let's go and just turn it off while it gets investigated. But otherwise, yeah, awesome.
Hold on past John T, it's present John T here, telling the fine folks watching this video how they can win a copy of this game. The developers, Tiny Build, are doing a giveaway that will run for the next 7 days as this video goes live. So you've got a week today to enter. The prizes are Steam access codes for this game, and there are loads of different ways to enter, including simple things like joining their Discord server and retweeting them on Twitter. You can find a link in the description to the competition. Best of luck. Go get them.
Yeah, we'll definitely keep an eye on this one, I think, folks. I've enjoyed it. And if you have, make sure you check out the top link in the description. That'll take you through to Steam, where you can pick this up now. Like I say, they've just had a big update that's added a lot of these features in. I'm sure if you saw our demo version of it a little while back, you'll definitely have noticed a big chunk of upgrades, which is really good. And make sure you go and follow Cartel Tycoon on all of their various social medias as well. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. Until the next one, be good.